folks. All right, this week, how about a feel-good story? Well, at least that's what it was to me when I heard about it. So I heard about this lady who saw a niche and created a business to fill it, and it was brilliant, in my opinion, the way she went about it. Here's the niche she saw that needed addressing. Technology is all around us. I mean, those of us who are used to dealing with it on a day-to-day basis, it's not that big a deal. But for older adults and senior citizens in particular, it can be very intimidating. And it's everywhere you go. They can't get away from it. Their cable remote, if they have a DVR, cameras today, it's not like the old Instamatics that they were used to. MP3 players instead of a boombox, you know. Then, of course, we've got smartphones. Oh, my gosh, way different than what they're used to dealing with. So, anyway, there's all this technology. And seniors can be very intimidated by it. So she realized that there was a need, someone to teach these older adults and senior citizens how to use all this technology. And she came up with the absolute perfect people to use as teachers, kids. By that I mean 16, 17, 18-year-olds, and you know, into the early 20s perhaps. These are people who have totally grown up with technology. That's all they've ever known. They wouldn't even know about having to go and turn the channel on a television or dial a telephone. I mean, they're not used to all the old stuff that us older folks are used to. It's all been whiz-bang technology for them. And they take to it like there's no tomorrow. I mean, you could put a brand new gadget in these kids' hands that they've never used before, and I bet within 5 minutes they got it totally dialed in. It's almost like an innate ability. So she's using these kids as the teachers for the senior citizens. And to me, this is like a win-win-win solution. The seniors get one-on-one tutoring with their newfangled gadgets that they're having a hard time figuring out. And the best part is that what she does is her tutors go to them. In other words, it's not like they have to get into the car and drive to the Apple store and sit and wait at the Genius Bar for someone to help them. No, basically the tutors come to them. It's a win for the kids because they're earning a paycheck and they're learning some important life skills. They're learning patience, because if you've ever taught technology to a senior citizen, you know it can be difficult sometimes. They're learning manners. I'm sure this woman won't tolerate her kids being rude to her clients. And they're learning responsibility. It's great. And they're getting off their duffs instead of watching, you know, TV or playing video games or whatever. They're doing something productive. It's dynamite for these kids. And it's a win for the lady because it's a business model. She's making money, of course. What she charges for the classes is more than what she pays the kids. You know, there's a profit for her. So it's a win-win-win. Now, part of what makes her business model so perfect where she's in Florida. And if you know anything about the U.S., in particular about Florida, you know that we have an extremely high percentage of retirees, people who retire to the Sunshine State. Well, that means that we've got an abundance of what are called retirement communities. Now, some of these are individual homes, sometimes they're what are called villas or duplexes, maybe it's an apartment complex or a condo unit, a lot of times it's a mobile home park. But they're communities that have an age limit. You have to be age 55 or older to live there. And these retirement communities usually have some kind of central meeting hall, rec center kind of a building that they, you know, play bingo or do craft stuff or whatever for the whole community. But it's right there on premises, basically. And that's what this lady's done. She's basically contracted with these various retirement communities with a schedule that she would have her kids there to teach the seniors, the residents, how to use their various gadgets. And so they don't have to get in their car and drive someplace. They just walk, or, and here in Florida, a lot of them have golf carts. They just drive the little golf carts to the rec center and get their lessons. So it's great for them because then they don't have to drive. On top of teaching them all about the gadgets themselves, these kids are also doing things like helping them set up a Facebook page or create a YouTube channel, how to upload photos or videos to their computers and up onto the internet. So they're not just teaching them how to use the gadget, but how to get the most out of the gadget. I think it's just a brilliant idea. I was thrilled when I read about this lady because I thought, wow, how perfect for everybody. Everybody wins in this scenario. So there you go, a nice feel-good story. And maybe it's a business idea for you. I'm sure that wherever you are, there are retirees, there are senior citizens who are having a hard time using their gadgets. So maybe you could do a similar thing that this lady has done. Start up a business and hire some kids to teach these senior citizens how to get the most out of their technology. Hope you do. If you do, let me know. Tell me about it. That's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.